So today I would like to share some work that we have done earlier this year in the area of deploying Shiny Apps and creating a custom website gallery. In particular, I will be showing how we have made SMARP, a Shiny App that we have been developing as an R package on GitHub, how we have made it, how it has made its way to the cloud, in particular a Kubernetes cluster, and from there it has been exposed to be finally embedded in the gallery of our website. So everything starts with an app, which is developed as an R package on GitHub. There are many advantages, and there will be talks at USAR about why you should probably think about developing a Shiny app as an R package. But in this context, the key aspect is that if you want to run an app, you need to install the package and call an exported function to launch the app. Now, we want to bring this to a Kubernetes cluster, and in particular using a Google Cloud as a cloud provider. And if, for those of you who are not very familiar with Kubernetes, it is a very popular and powerful container and cluster orchestration system to manage and deploy containerized applications. This means that you need to package your application as a container, using Docker in particular. This is based on some instructions defined in a Docker file. This is an extract of the Docker file for SMARP. And you see that everything starts with an image with a base R. In this case, we are using a version stable R image from the Great Rocker project. We need to make sure that we install all the dependencies, both library, system libraries and packages of the package, install the SMARP package itself. And eventually, and most importantly, we need to launch the application in a way which is accessible on an exposed port. Now, if we want to bring this to Kubernetes, we need to build the image and make it available on a container registry. And the natural choice here was Google Container Registry. This is done using Docker build and Docker push. And if you have attended the tutorial from yesterday, you should be already familiar with these techniques. Once the Docker image is available on a registry, we can basically use the command line tool kubectl to instruct Kubernetes to create a deployment called SMARP from the image that we have put on the data on the container registry. In fact, in Kubernetes, a deployment manages a set of replicas of your app by running so-called pods in a way which is flexible, dynamic, and most importantly, scalable. What we have seen here is a way to deploy an app in an ad hoc way, so a one-off deployment. But what you probably want to have on top of it is a continuous delivery pipeline. For the case of SMARP, we are using a simple Git flow approach where we basically push to the master branch only when we want to release a new version of the app. Then with the Google Cloud and the Google Cloud build component, we can set a trigger that would react on such push event and execute some steps defined in a cloud build YAML file. These are the relevant steps, and you can recognize here the very same build and push commands associated, in fact, with the commit hash of the push event. Besides this, there is a command which is called set image that would, update the existing development called SMARP to use the new image that we have just made available. So with this, we basically managed to have our app running as a set of pods on Kubernetes, possibly alongside another app, another pods, like the Magenta guys here. And what we want to do is, though, to expose this and make it accessible through a nice URL under HTTPS so that we can embed it in our HTTPS-based website. So how to do this? In Kubernetes, you do this mainly with defining two resources. One is a node port and the other is an ingress. A node port basically allows you to define a service backend for your app and thereby abstracting from the way Kubernetes spins off pods and runs the app in different replicas in different nodes of the cluster. So what a node port would do is basically taking external requests, or requests that come from outside the cluster, and forward them on a given port to the running nodes, which would be available at that time. Besides this, we then need an ingress, which is a way to make the app accessible through an external public IP address, and taking care of routing the HTTPS traffic to the actual service backend. So to do this in practice, in fact, in Kubernetes, you define the specs of you can define the specs of any resource using a so-called YAML manifest, and you can then create the resource using the kubectl apply minus -f command. So let's look at the details about the node port service backend that we want to create. We give it a name, service backend, that you see at the top. This is used for referencing the backend in other resources. That's very important. And at the very bottom, you see that we are basically telling this node port service which are the pods that we want to forward the request to. And in this case, of course, we care only about the pods that are running smart, in particular using the port 80, which is the port on which we have exposed the app. You also see in the middle something called backend config. This is something quite tricky, so we need, in fact, to define or associate another little resource to this node port backend, which is a configuration. And why do we need this? This is the YAML manifest of the backend configuration. And the tricky thing about Shiny apps is that they are based on WebSockets, and WebSockets on HTTP have, by default, a very, very short connection timeout. So if you wouldn't do this and increase the timeout to, for example, 3 hours, which is more reasonable for an interactive app, you would have your users reaching your app, and after 30 seconds, bam, the app grays out, and you have to reload the page and start all over again, which is not a very nice user experience. So with this node port, we basically have a backend for our app, and we want to expose it with an ingress. In fact, it's not just about this static IP, because we really want to enable HTTPS, so secure traffic, on a custom domain or subdomain in this case. So we need, configuring the ingress, we need, to get, in any case, a static IP address, and we can ask Google Cloud, in this case, to provide one for us. We can give it a name called a Smart IP. And based on what we actually get out, we need to configure our DNS. So with our domain registrar, we need to add a new record that would associate the domain that we want to serve our app with the address that Google Cloud has provided for us. You have to bear in mind that this can take some time. It's a matter probably of a few hours for the record to spread around the globe, basically. And once this is done, you can test it with Ping, for example. Once this is done, you also need, on top of this, to have a certificate. A TLS certificate is what enables secure connections over HTTPS. This is fairly simple, in fact, with Google Cloud, because it provides Google-managed certificates, which you can, again, define in a pretty easy way with a YAML manifest, where you give it a name, Smart Certificate, and you just have to mention which domain you want to create your certificate for. So now that we have all the ingredients in place on the backend and on the domain side, we are ready to define our ingress. So this is, again, the YAML file that will be used to create the ingress. And you see at the very bottom that we are just routing traffic to the backend that we have created on port 80, which is the one that we have used to expose the app. And there are a few annotations where you basically specify the other ingredients. So you can specify the IP address, the static IP address that we have created, the certificate that we have created, and in particular, in this case, we are also completely turning off HTTP traffic, so forcing secure connections to our app. One last comment about the certificate and the ingress is that you have to be patient with them. So once you ask Kubernetes to create these resources, it will take some time to basically provision the certificate and to set up all the forwarding rules for the ingress. So be patient, you can monitor the status of the resources with the kubectl described with a watch in front. And once you see thing being finalized in the status and ready, you can visit the app using the URL. So once we have it, then what is the next step? We want to use this nice URL to embed the app in our gallery. So to this, in general, in the HTML world, if you want to embed a document and a page in another page, you use iframes. So this is the standard way of doing it. And this is what you also find when you want to embed a YouTube video. If you click on the embed icon, the same with Google Maps, you get an iframe, basically, with a pretty similar configuration. So this is a pretty standard way of doing it. And if you try that, and that, of course, that's what we tried first, what you get is something like this. So you only see a fixed amount of your page. Why this? The tricky part here is that iframes don't really react and respond on the geometry of the content that you are embedding. For this reason, you need to find a workaround. And what we are using in this context is a JavaScript library called the iframe resizer. It's an open source library that everyone can access and use. And the way to use it is basically on both sides. You need to include some JavaScript code in the website page hosting the app and also in the app itself. So in particular, these two JavaScript code would talk to each other, and the hosting web page will be notified or ask the app about events that would change the geometry. So you see here that in the case of the hosting web page, you need to include the JavaScript code. You need to give an ID to the iframe, and then basically execute this script that would take care of interacting with what? With the JavaScript code that we have placed in our Shiny app in a pretty standard way, for example, in the head of the Shiny app. So this is basically the theory. We have actually combined this into our website, which is a website based on Jekyll. Jekyll, I don't know if you are familiar with it, but this is the static website generator, which is behind GitHub Pages, for example. It's a very powerful, easy to use, blog-aware site-side generator, and it happened to be the engine that we used already for our existing website. It has quite a few features, and in the context of creating a gallery for Shiny apps, you can basically define just a markdown file for each of the apps that you might want to have. So this is a smart.md file with just metadata in a YAML header about how the app is called, and most importantly, the URL that you want to embed. Then you can include a so-called liquid template, which does all the iframe magic that we have seen before, and it would do it for the specific URL of any of the apps that you want to have in your gallery. So you can have an arbitrary number of empty files under the gallery section of the website, and this template will take care of doing all the iframe magic for you. On top of this, you can use Jekyll for other nice things, like creating this drop-down menu in a dynamic way. And for this, you need yet another set of metadata in the YAML file, like what is the entry of Smarp. And then the key part of the code that would create the gallery menu dynamically is basically looping over the pages and check if a page is part of the gallery and just create an entry with the text that we have defined here, with a link to the actual page of the app. So as a summary of this very like a quick and fast introduction to the full workflow, which is in fact requiring quite a few steps and required quite a few iterations at our end. We basically started from a Shiny app developed as an R package. We basically had to figure out how to bring it to Kubernetes, using in particular the Google Kubernetes engine. Also taking care of continuous delivery using Git flow. Git is great for this stuff. We were already using it, and it was basically natural to add a trigger on top of what we were already doing. And then exposing the app with an HTTPS URL. And finally, taking care of creating this app for our specific page, and we found Jekyll as a very nice starting point. More in general, this is a pretty ground-up approach. which you could argue that, I mean, I could argue that this can bring a lot of flexibility if you want to really fine-tune and have a lot of control of each of individual steps. This is, of course, true. But I found it particularly interesting because this was a very good chance to get a lot of insights and knowledge into a technology stack, which is not just serving this purpose, but it is also used in many of the existing off-the-shelf tools. So we have seen yesterday, for those of you who attended the tutorial, Shiny Proxy, and there were a lot of similar concepts in terms of Docker, something mentioned about Kubernetes. So this actually helps a lot understanding what is behind these tools, which can be also of great value. So this was a very quick and condensed summary of what we have done. That's why I added at the end of the presentation and the slides quite a few links. There is something within SMARP, in particular this README, which describes more in detail all the process for deploying and exposing the app, and then a bunch of very useful starting points if you want to know more about Kubernetes, and in particular, Kubernetes on Google Cloud. And I'll be happy to take questions now or later during the break. Thank you.